Come on, girl. Come on.
So the whole piece is all about how we all are supposed to be fitting into these little boxes of life and how we have to check the box and stay there. And we're labeled. Right, those boxes, right? So the name of the piece is I Refuse.
Okay.
I refuse to be what you expect. To hide the parts of me in neglect. To be the sum of the whole that you want to reject. To show only what you're proud to see. To beg for your respect.
Wow.
I'm a woman reveling in my own duality. A riddle wrapped in a conundrum. That's my reality. I'm not the stigma forced by society. A good woman isn't all about propriety. I refuse to spend my free time shopping, to take selfies endlessly and cropping.
What's he back here?
I refuse to spend my focus on hair and makeup, spending hours getting ready. That's just too early to make up. I refuse to be quiet during games. If the ref blows a call, I won't be tame.
Right.
I refuse to ignore my comic book collection, even if it means your haughty rejection. That's not ladylike, is an ignorant phrase. Who are you to tell me how to amaze? There are so many other ways to earn God's praise than to be a clone. The idea makes the eyes blaze. A capable wife means so much more than just being some sweetheart that others adore. I get it. There's a time and a place to be quiet, demure, to learn, to listen, to care, to cure. God says I too can be reasonable, logical, make good decisions, be practical, to have wisdom, insight, display discernment. My passion cannot be labeled PMS, requiring internment. I don't want to dissect to death a subject topic, to be spoiled, play games, threaten to walk. In fact, if that is what men have come to expect, it's no wonder that most of these relationships end in regret. No, sir. I refuse to be her. Thank you.